Welcome children, hope you all are revising the earlier work and you are ready to continue the remaining part of the chapter. So let's start. So children, we are continuing our chapter 2 measurement and our topic is measuring masses. So what is mass? Students, if we have a glass and a jug, both are full of water. Which one will be heavier? Of course, a glass of water feels lighter than a jug of water. Why it is so? It is because the quantity of water in the glass is less than the quantity of water contained in the jug. Hence, mass is defined as the quantity of matter contained in a body. In our day-to-day life, we refer to mass as weight, but it is scientifically wrong. Mass represents the amount of matter contained in a body, whereas weight is the force of gravity acting on an object. Now, if we talk about the units of mass, the standard unit of mass is kilogram and it is written as kg. Now, the small quantities of substances are expressed in the units of gram and milligram. Here 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram and 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram. Same as larger quantities of substances are expressed in the unit of quintal or ton. 1 quintal is equal to 100 kilograms or 1 ton is equal to 10 quintal. There are many instruments available for measuring weights or mass. The most commonly used balances are beam balance, physical balance and electronic balance. See, this is a simple form of a commonly used beam balance. It consists of a horizontal beam of iron supported at the center by an iron loop. Two similar pens are suspended equal distances from the center of the beam by means of strings or iron chains of equal lengths. A vertical pointer, this is the pointer, a vertical pointer is fixed at the center of the iron loop. You must have noticed shopkeeper weigh goods using this balance. A beam balance is said to be true if its beams remains horizontal and the pointer vertical when its pens are empty or equal weights are placed on them. Now, next one is physical balance. A beam balance that can measure mass up to 1 milligram or less is known as physical balance. Or we can say a physical balance is a modified and highly sensitive version of the beam balance. Okay, the principle on which a physical balance works is the same as that of a beam balance. It is generally used in a science laboratory or in a jewelry shop to measure the mass of gold or other precious things accurately. A physical balance consists mainly of a beam and two scale pens. The beam made of brass or aluminum is light and strong. It has one pointer and three knife edges. Two pens of equal mass are suspended at the two ends of the beam from the other two knife edges. The pointer moves over the scale fixed at the base of the pillar. The balance is kept in a glass case to protect it from dust and save the balance from being disturbed by air current during its use. You might have seen this in jewelry shops. Another device is electronic balance. An electronic balance is a device used to find accurate measurement of mass. It is used very commonly in laboratories for weighing chemicals to ensure a precise measurement of those chemicals for use in various experiments. Electronic balances may also be used to weigh food and other grocery items. You might have seen this. Electronic balances have gained popularity in the modern world. Electronic devices have got certain advantages. In comparison to the physical balances, and electronic devices have got certain advantages. Such devices are easy to use and have fast calculations. Such balances use coil and magnet arrangement to create a comparison, comparing weight of required value by giving the rise to electromagnetic force. Weight generated is displayed on the digital scale. This is the digital scale, and you can see the weight here. It will come in digits. So, our next topic is measuring time. First of all, what is time? Time is defined as the gap between two events. The standard unit of measuring time is second. The larger units of time than second are minute and hour. And you all know the relation between these three units are units is 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. The bigger units of time for expressing longer time intervals are day, month, and year. 24 hours make 1 day, 30 days make 1 month, and 12 months make 1 year. The still bigger units for expressing very long time intervals are decade, century, and millennium. 10 years is equal to 1 decade, 100 years is equal to 1 century, and 1000 years make 1 millennium. Now we will talk about the time measuring devices. Children, in ancient times, people used some natural events which repeated regularly. The earlier men estimated time by looking at the sun and the moon. For example, the time between sunrise to sunset, or the duration between one full moon to another full moon. Now children, listen carefully. A motion which repeats itself at regular intervals of time is called periodic motion, and the principle of periodic motion is used for the measurement of time. One of the most common devices which show periodic motion is the simple pendulum. The principle of periodic motion is even used nowadays in the mechanically operated wall clocks, wristwatch, watches, and clocks. Some of the important time measuring devices used in ancient times were sundial, sand clock, and water clock. An early device for measuring time was referred to as sundial. A sundial measures time by the position of the shadow cast by the sun. Due to apparent movement of the sun in the sky, the position of the shadow of a vertical object changes continuously throughout the day. Some historical sundials still exist in India. You can see these sundials in Jantar Mantar in Delhi and Jaipur. But these sundials have one limitation also. These sundials
cannot be used after sunset.
Another early device for measuring time was the sand clock. Sand clock is also known as sand glass or hourglass. The sand clock uses the flow of sand from one glass bulb to another to measure time. The length of time taken by the sand to pass from one bulb of the sand clock to the other gives a constant time interval. Another ancient device used to measure the time is simple water clock. A water clock uses the rate at which water drips from one vessel to another to measure time intervals. Water was allowed to drip from one vessel to another vessel kept at a lower level. The time taken by the entire water to drip from upper vessel to lower vessel was used for measuring time intervals. Every time the upper vessel is filled with water, its water takes exactly the same time to drip into the lower vessel. Now, if we talk about the modern devices to measure the time, first of all, we will talk about a clock or a watch. It is a device to measure time in hours and minutes. Some clocks may be provided with a second hand apart from the hour and minute hands. One more modern clock is digital watch. It is a device to measure time. It has a digital display screen showing hours, minutes, and sometimes seconds also. You all must have seen this watch. Another device is a stopwatch. It is a device which helps to measure the time taken for a particular event. Such type of devices are used in modern day sports event which requires a very high degree of precision. It is marked in seconds. This watch has to reset to zero every time before measuring the time. Most of the clocks and watches these days use quartz crystal for measuring time. Quartz is a hard mineral consisting of silica. The time measured by quartz clocks and watches is much more accurate. There are some clocks which can measure time intervals as small as microsecond or even a nanosecond. So students, we will continue our chapter in our next video. Till then, thank you and bye-bye.